Good morning and welcome to Spicetown. It's not spice, but spites. It's spelled and pronounced as Spicetown, but the height is spelled as eight. So I think I should get a glimpse of it. But anyways, today I'm on a solo trip or solo journey to Oysters. I want to find myself once more in Oysters, have a couple of things to do, COVID test as well before I fly back. All right, here it is, but I want to show you around before I go inside. Speightstown is a town inside St. Peter's right now where I'm living. Getting here from my apartment is quite easy. All right, see a lot of buses there, but I don't know which one is my terminal, so I guess I should go inside and see things for myself. Speightstown bus terminal, let's see how it looks like. No bicycles, no skating allowed. Not sure why, perhaps to reduce the noise. Dad, Disabilities Awareness Day. Learn the way to an inclusive society. Nice. So that's it. Speightstown. Spelled like eight, but it's pronounced as eight. Speightstown bus terminal. Cashier here. Can I buy some ticket to Oysters? Not sure. There's no one here absolutely to sell the tickets. Probably I should ask around. So, someone. Good morning. Do you sell the tickets to Oysters? Uh-uh. Where can I buy it? In the bus?
I don't think this. I don't hear no more.
Okay, you don't deal with tickets?
Uh-uh.
Okay, thank you. Alright, she was opening the door to the cashier here. But she doesn't deal with tickets. Okay, I wonder who deals with it then. Right, back to what I was saying. I've got a couple of things to do in Oysters. So, this is the bus that takes me on a 2-hour journey from St. James to Oysters. But I don't know which terminal. I can see Oysters here. Perhaps Oysters is not the final destination, but a destination along the way. Okay, I have to go check it out. Found it, Oysters. So my bus is gonna wait here and take me to Oysters. So I think before it comes, I should do a bit of walking and turning around before it comes. I can't stress this enough. People in Barbados are very, very skeptical about cameras. Just a second ago, the lady there was questioning why I was filming. Like, I don't know. This is not North Korea. This is a tourist country, so I don't see any reasons why I cannot film or at least show people where I am and what's going on in this country. So I really don't get it. Comment below if you know why people here are very camera shy or camera skeptical, and over there is no bullying zone, so I think she's bullying me right now. Okay, let's say I'm not supposed to film here, then the question should be why. Again, let's say I'm not supposed to film here, then there should be a camera, there should be a warning that I shouldn't film here. But anyways, that's not the point. This is Speightstown bus terminal, in case you're wondering.
Hold on, please.
Okay.
Can you speak quickly?
Yeah, give me a second. Yes, and I made it. It's not so difficult to get around this country without having to buy or pay for a very expensive taxi. But if you've got good people on the island, they could hook you up with someone who would charge you a price that is reasonable. But anyways, that's not the point. The point is that people are nice here, although some of them are camera shy. If you don't know your way around, you can always ask a question. You can see other guys trooping in, of course, to get their COVID test done. And I'm gradually getting closer to my final day in this country. But yeah, hope you've had a little bit of taste of this country yet. If not, just let me know what more you would like to see. I have at least 2 more days remaining on the island, and yeah, trust me, I can use it to grab something for you. But yeah, on my first day out of the apartment to get tested, if you remember, I was here, was around here. But now I'm about to go get tested for COVID before I could board my flight. But look at that. What the F? My God. COVID testing is a $1 trillion industry. I mean, look at this. Hope I can survive a day with this much people. This whole queue. Alright. Let's go get it done then. Alright, that was it. Done with the COVID test, the 7th time. I'm doing this since the pandemic. 7th. And the woman of today, I thought she would be better than the one of last time, if you remember. But nah, man. She said she was from Cuba. Spoke a little bit of Spanish with her. And I was wondering, what are Cubans doing here? She was like, the COVID testing contract was given to them, to their unit of clinic in Cuba, so they have to move in here to do it. So I wonder why, but like, it's not for me to decide.